Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the peace and grace of our Lord Jesus Christ be
with you. One Carmelite lady who went to near the seashore carrying her baby. When she reached there, she threw the baby to a stone. She thought the baby died. While she was going back, she heard the baby crying. Again, she went there and picked up the baby, lifted baby, and throw the baby against the stone once again. And she confirmed the baby is died and she went back. We all read the news. She did it to run away with her new boyfriend. Before that, we read another news. One father bet the child a lot. At the end, he held the legs of the baby and beat the baby against the wall and broke even the scalp of the baby. We read the news. 2 days before, a sad news, same from Kerala. Two boys, they study in 9th standard. They called their friend who studies in 10th standard. They went to a place and they cut this boy with the axe and buried the baby there in rubber plantation. How come that too in Kerala? I'm still burning, you know. I don't know how to express my grief. Now you may be asking, you may be thinking, why Brother Mario saying all these things? Yesterday, I received a phone call from one of my friend. He said, Brother, I need your help. I said, what? Me and my son not talking last 3 days. Please be a counselor and solve the issues. I asked him, what happened? I never bit my child, brother. 3 days before, I was quite angry and I bit him. I said, why you were angry? He said, I am at home only. I cannot go out. I am frustrated. And my wife is nagging continuously and we are quarreling. In between, the children also very, very bad. And it's a headache. I could not control myself, so I bit. I said, how many times you bit? Only one, but it hurt baby and he's not talking. I'm really suffering. So anyway, I made a video call, spoke to the husband, wife and children, and now they are reconciled, everything is okay. Again, he called me back and said, Brother Mario, can you upload a video regarding the same? I said, what? Now, due to quarantine, all are at home. So there is problem between husband and wife, between parents and children, between siblings. So if you can upload a video, can we beat our children or no? That will be helpful for many parents. I said, okay, I will. Now, this is the same video. Can we beat our children? If, then, how? When? Where? Why? Many questions, correct? Now, before answering, can we beat or no? Let me answer you the psychological answer. What are the consequences of beating your children? Not what are the benefits of beating your child, but what are the consequences of beating your child? The demerits of beating your children. The first demerits or the bad consequences of beating your child is it lowers their self-esteem. If you beat your child from childhood onwards, definitely that is going to affect their self-esteem. And if the self-esteem is affected and if it is lowered, the life is lost. Why? Because they will never have a guts to deal with anything. They will never be able to lead a very good social life or the family life. So be careful, do not beat your child unnecessarily. And the psychologist says, the second bad consequences of beating your child, it instills the fear in your children. Slowly, slowly, it is like a little drop makes mighty ocean, little fear grows in them slowly. The fear of father, fear of mother, fear of teachers, fear of siblings, fear of wrongdoings. Slowly, slowly that fear grows and they will be afraid of everything. They will, in near future, they will be afraid of darkness. They will be afraid of lizard or insect. They will be afraid of meeting an interview. They will be afraid of exam. They will be afraid of public traveling. Everywhere there will be fear. And if you don't want your child to have unwanted fear and destroy their life, please stop beating your children unnecessarily. And the third bad consequences of beating your child unnecessarily is it triggers the aggressiveness in your child. And not only that, it creates frustration and fear in your child. Which means, if you keep beating your child, the first thing, they will be aggressive. Your child will be sitting and studying. You say, come, lunch is ready. No response. Again, you said, come, lunch is ready. No response. Maybe 10 times you say, the 11th time child gets up. Hearing, but not understanding. They pretend they did not hear. They pretend they did not see. They will become very aggressive and disobedient. And if your son or daughter is one among, remember that you were beating your child or yelling at your child unnecessarily. And the fourth consequence is that they will be frustrated and angry for everything. They may break even things, you know. Now your son, if you keep beating him very often, when he calls his friend, suppose if he did not get the line within one phone call, he may throw the phone out. He's searching for the pen, he did not get the pen, so he will even, study table even, because he's frustrated. And if this is happening with your son or daughter, be careful. You know, you did something wrong somewhere, at least by yelling at them. And then, the fifth consequence is that, if you beat your child, they will develop the same tendency to beat others. They may beat their colleagues, they may beat their siblings. When they grew up, they may beat even the parents. My brothers and sisters, however naughty your son or daughter is, should not beat them unnecessarily. That brings over damage for your children. It will never bring any good for their future. Now there will be a question, Brother Mario, what you said is absolutely true, but when my son or daughter behaves so abnormal, how can we control ourselves? Then tell us some way that we can do some goodness for them. First training, what you should give to the child according to Bible, we read Malachi chapter 2 verses 15. And did not he make one, yet had he the residue of the spirit? And wherefore one? That he might seek a godly seed. When God united men and women in marriage sacrament, what he expects from the sacrament is godly children. So the first training for the children is awareness of God. My parents, my brothers and sisters, you may educate your child in many ways. Technology, science and sociology, natural things, everything. But if you do not create God awareness in your son and in your daughter, their future is lost. You will be disappointed with them, no doubt. Because everything they know except mercy and compassion. From your technology, they may not learn the mercy and compassion. From your mathematics, they may not learn mercy and compassion. From your sociology, they may not learn compassion and mercy. That comes only by the awareness of the Creator. If they know that there is a Creator of this universe and He loves every creature equally, and He loves human beings so much so that He sent His only Son for human beings, the person who is aware of this will be very merciful and very kind, and they will be successful in all their ways. Once again, let me tell you, my brothers and sisters, the first thing what you have to train or what you have to teach your child is God awareness. Second thing what you have to teach your child, I read from Deuteronomy chapter 6 verses 7, and thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children, and shall talk of them when thou sittest in thine house, and when thou walkest by the way, and when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. Word of God says, you must teach the children the word of God. You must talk about the word of God in the house. You must talk about the word of God when you are going for a walk, or when you are going to park, when you are going for a tour. And you must meditate about them when you lie down, when you rise up, 24/7 you must meditate about the word of God and you must teach that to your children. We are educating our children in many ways except in the word of God. That is the worst situation of Catholics all over the world. I don't know from where you are listening to me, but let me give a clue to understand how good you are with the word of God. Imagine you are a 70-year-old man. Out of that 70, 10 years you remove from your life, which means from birth till 10 years you don't remember anything. So consider that you didn't leave that 10 years. Now anyway, 60 years you lived. Per year, if you memorize one word from Bible, now you can recite 60 verses from Bible. But can you recite it, my brother, my sister? I'm asking you, can you recite 60 verses now? No. Which means you did not memorize one word from Bible once in a year. Not even once in a year. Then what's the point of going to church every Sunday? Celebrating all the, you know, attending all novenas and all the rosary, everything, but you didn't memorize one word once in a year? So sad. This is something very important. You know what I do with my children? Every day I read Bible, and if any word touched my heart, I ask my children to write down on the wall. I gave a board, it's there in my home, they write that word. 1 or 2 days that remains there, and very often we read and we all memorize. And then another word I give. My brothers and sisters, teach your child to memorize one word from Bible every Sunday. And you, if it is possible, you also do. If cannot, at least once in a month one word, which means once in a year 12 words. So now you are 60-year-old or 70-year-old or 80-year-old. So 80 into 12, how many verses would have been there in your life? Two things to understand. The first thing, you must